sorry, guys. I've been looking on YouTube, and it's hard to find Dilfer, Clint Lathenberg. It's hard to find a good video of how to take this apart. Everyone runs through it and then fast forwards it through it, so I'm going to go at regular speed so y'all can see all what it takes. You need the heat gun, and then as you can see on mine, it's been broken before by the previous owner, so I'm going to have to be real careful how I hold that. So I'm just going to start heating it up. Last time with this one, I started at this corner in here, so I could pry it out. And we didn't heat it up enough, so it took us a while to get it done. So this one we're going to do a little better. So I'm going to start on the corner that I'm in. Really, bro. It's a lot of fun. So I just had my car painted. You can see the overspray that the guy got on the car. It was a cheap paint job, but it came out alright. And we're going to start doing more videos that explain more than other videos that I've seen. So it'll be a little more in-depth of what I've found so far. I wish I would have filmed taking out the headlights, but I didn't. It's gonna be a long, boring video, but I just want you guys to see how long it actually takes. And I've already knocked off the metal tabs. They're real easy to get with the flathead. You just pop them off. There's four of them. Two on the top, two on the bottom. You can see this was repaired very bad, so me and Dilfer are going to put some more JB Weld on there so it holds a little stronger, because these lights are really expensive to buy aftermarket, or not aftermarket, but used. They don't make them aftermarket. If you have a Kooky, you can find all kinds of lights for it, but not the Zinky. So, I see why everybody fast forward through this part, because it is very slow, tedious, but it's really important, because on the first one, we didn't heat up enough, and it took us forever to rip it apart. I got this side that I'm gonna attack first pretty hot right now, so I'm gonna give it a try and see how it goes. I mean, people say you could put it in the oven, which you can. I think it'd be a lot easier to do it that way. Put it in the oven for like 5 minutes. At 350, I think would be good. We've done that to computer motherboards and they're fine. It smells a little weird, but it works out fine. So the surface silicone is coming off pretty easy, which is a good sign. And sorry for the lighting, guys. This is our first video, so we'll make things a little better as we go. So on the first one, I think I started it here, didn't I, Delsbury? Mm-hmm. Mom is gonna come in here and mess up this video. I'm making a video. Don't put her on it.
I didn't.
I'm trying to find a good place that I can get this screwdriver started in here. I'm pretty sure last time I did it in here. Quit laughing, bro. Once you find a place to get it started, you can start working it. But there's so much gunk and stuff on this from doing it last time. I'm gonna have to cut it off. See, this is all the little stuff they don't show you on the other videos that I don't like it. Damn. Try to get a little hotter right there. I'm not really worried about messing up the light, and the housing can take a little damage. Yeah, here it comes. I can feel it. I need like a skinnier screwdriver. Come on, baby. There, got it in there. You can see it's starting to pull out. Go around this edge where they can see that. See it's starting to come out. I'm gonna take the knife and just run along it real quick. It's weird. Last time I had Dilsberg helping me, but now he's holding the camera, so I gotta try to do it on my own. So once I get it gapped enough, I'll put the other screwdriver in. That's the silicone popping. Or caulking. Silicone caulking. There we go. See, I'm starting to get some movement here. So now that that's in there like that, I'll heat it up a little more. And as soon as you heat it up, all the parts that were sticking, they like break apart. See how much more movement you get? Are you getting it down in here? Let me move this. Alright, now that that part's nice and loose, I'll get this hot again. Start working down that way. That was close. Alright. You got this? Okay, now it's gapped down here. I can start getting under there a little bit. If you can get the screwdriver deep enough in there, you can heat it up with the heat gun and break it apart a lot easier. Last time I could grab here. Last time I could grab up here, but I can't this time. What are you filming?
You.
Yeah, I want to pull on this so bad. So close to fitting in there. This is very time consuming and frustrating, but it's definitely worth it. Once I get this corn out pretty good, then I can just yank on it and pull it apart. You just have to get a good start to it. Cut some of this stuff away. Silicone makes everything so hard. I'm gonna work on this part a little bit more so it can. But this is why I say I think the oven would be a lot easier, because you're getting it all hot at the same time, evenly. Alright, let me try to work this a little more. It's coming. I'm not really worried about when I'm turning it like that, these little plastic pieces. Don't really bother me. I don't think it's gonna affect anything. And you definitely won't see it. It's wanting to come apart, it's just getting stuck right in here. So that means you gotta heat this freaking part up again. I had Dylan helping me, he could come in through here while I'm pulling on it and try to cut away the silicone. Damn. Here we go. She's a coming. So saying, once you get it past this, that one initial part, it's always good if most of the caulking comes out with the glass, the plastic, and not in your housing, because you have to clean up all the housing, like get all the old silicone out of there, so your new one will fit flush. So I just started on this corner here, worked it, got this nice and warm, and once you're able to pry that off, and remember I started prying right at this little plastic piece on the top of the headlight where the clip holds in. that is part one of the clear lens replacement on the S14 240SX Zinke. And the next step will be getting all this gunk out. I don't know if I'll video that. It's pretty boring and it's time consuming also, but I'll just show you real quick. Just heat it up, get it nice and warm. And once you get that, get the flathead in there and scrape it up. Pull it off. Be sure it's not too hot when you pull it off, because it'll stick to your fingers and you won't be able to get off. It's really hot, burning. And then just keep doing that. The hotter you keep it, the easier it is to clean it out. All right, guys, part two will be putting the lens on and prepping the lights. On this light, you can see here, this metal piece. I think that's so you don't blind people with your regular headlights. It looks kind of ugly, but when it's actually on the car, it doesn't look that bad. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with that yet. I gotta think about it. But we'll see you at part two if you need it.